Hello again. At first, have to ask how many of you planned to attend the workshop after the lunch? Are the cameras ready to start? Okay. Good morning again. My name is Michael Oelhoff. I show you how to set up a local development environment for your projects in very short time. I will, at the beginning, tell you something about the different technologies that can be used and are used to set up a local environment. Native installation on your machine, using virtual machines, and using container technologies. And after the talk, you will have the knowledge to set up a local development environment for your projects within a couple of minutes. So, give me some minutes to say some words about me and my Type 3 history. So I love programming since I bought my first computer. About 40 years ago. Anyone knows this art of home computer? Okay, since 2005, I'm in love with Type 3. At this time, I use the operating system Ecosystem Station OS 2. Anyone knows it? Oh, much more people. In those days, I have written some patches for the Type 3 3.8 to get it running on OS 2 and Ecosystem Station, because Type 3 thinks it is a Unix system and OS 2 is like a Windows for the file names and drive letters. And I held some talks at yearly Ecosystem Station conferences. Some years later, I tried to get a patch into the core. Nobody was interested. And 4 years later, we have closed it because I no longer use the Ecosystem Station. Today, I'm programming extensions for Type 3. Mostly make old custom extensions running on newer versions for some little companies. And since my first code sprint at the beginning of 2015, I also contribute to the core. And this is all done in my spare time. That should be enough for me. So, if you look back in time, there were different technologies to set up your local environment. You can install it native. You have to install the PHP interpreter. You have to install an Apache web server. You have to install a MySQL database. And you have to configure them all to get it running. And if you have more than one project, you have to configure it for each project. This maybe results in a lot of work. And then, there were people, they wanted to make it easier for you. They created packages like LAMP, WAMP, MEMP, EMPASS2, XAMPP, where I think you all know where the letters are for: A for the Apache, M for the MySQL, P for PHP, and for the operating systems, Linux, Windows, Mac OS, OS 2, and X stands for cross-platform. And when you're using these packages, it reduces the time to set up your local development environment in comparison to do it all by hand. So the mostly known is the XAMPP package, which is brought to us by the Apache friends. Can you guess who has made this package for OS2? It was me. From 2006 until 2012, I have created and maintained this package. So, next in time, there comes up the virtual machines. So you can set up one virtual machine per project. But you have to install the right operating system, the Apache web server, MySQL database, PHP interpreter inside the virtual machine for each project. This costs a lot of disk space and also a lot of time. If you install it native or in a virtual machine, you have to do the same setup. And then, there are people who create ready-to-use virtual machines. So you can get the machine, start it up, and have a running Type 3 where you can install your project-specific data. You can find them, for example, at Binami or the AWS Marketplace. And then there is one special vagrant box from Michi Rose called Type 3 Homestead, where you could set up a virtual machine with different Type 3 versions installed, the current major version and the latest LTS versions. I used this box 2-3 years ago to do reviews for the Type 3 core. And I have written some scripts to get the reviews from Garrett inside the box so you can have a view at the current version and the patched version from the review. Michiel has integrated this inside his Homestead box. But yesterday he told me it is no longer maintained. So when you use it today, you will get up a virtual machine with very big size. So virtual machines has the drawback that you have installed operating system in every virtual machine. It costs place on your hard disk, and so then the container technology comes up, where the programs run in isolated processes in the user space, sharing the operating system of your computer. I have written some, for example, the most known is Docker. With Docker, you can set up very easily, but you have to create your containers. You have to install the web server inside the container and so on. That may be also a lot of work. The complexity is that you have multiple containers, you have to connect them, which container connects to the other container, which ports, and so on. And then, there comes the people from Drud Technology, which combines some containers with an easy-to-use command line interface. So Docker is completely hidden for you. You only have to use DDEV. DDEV is an open source tool to set up your PHP projects. It uses Docker, as I said, and Docker Compose, the requirements you have on your local machine. So that should be the enough for the introduction part. Let's start some practical part where I show you how you can use it. As I said, requirement for DDEV is only using an operating system that is supported and have there installed the right Docker and Docker Compose version. You find information about the installation at their documentation, which is very good. So, take over to a demo. I will show you how to set up a Type 3 version 9. We have seen it in the talk before, how to do it. Is it on the right? Yes. So, big enough? Black on black. It's going. No full screen. Where is my mouse? So you already know what you're seeing here. So the Composer installation is ready. We switch into the directory where we've installed. And we call DDEV. Oh. At first, we DDEV config shows us in which directory we are, and that the config.yaml file will be created after the configuration. First question is about the project name. The default is the name of the directory you are currently in, but you can name it as you like. The second question is for the folder where the root of your web project is. For the Typo3 Composer base distribution, this is the public directory, so we only have to press enter. DDEV looks into the folder and find out that we have a Typo3 installation, so the type project type is currently set to Typo3. With the project type, DDEV decides to make some additional configuration for your project. For Typo3, it writes an additional configuration file in your Typo3 conf directory with all the database credentials, so you don't have to enter them yourself. So we are starting up DDEV. We see three containers are created. One, the DB is the database container. DBA is the database administrator container where a PHP admin is installed. And web is a web container. And the directory where we are is mounted inside the web container. So we see on which URLs we can reach our demo site. So we have to get a browser. Oops, we installed a Typo3 version 9 and we have missed some step. So DDEV comes with different PHP versions installed. You can choose between 5.6, 7.0, 7.1, and 7.2. But the default is 7.1. For Typo3 9, we have to change it. So we edit the config YAML in the .ddev directory and set the version to 7.2. To get it active, we have to restart the container. We also can stop and start the container, but restart is a bit faster. So let us reload the page. These steps are already known, I think. We have to create the first install file. So step one, environment looks good, so we can step over. And we have seen no questions about the database server, database connection. We create an admin user. And we just go to the backend. So here we are. If you have a good internet connection and have all the dependencies from Composer already local on your machine, so it can get from the cache, you can do these steps with Composer install, DDEV config, DDEV start, create admin user and login to the backend in about 2.5 minutes. And then you can start work on your new project. Oh. But there are also other ways to set up your Typo3. You also can install from the source. So we made a clone of the base distribution. So that was very fast. But I have forgotten something. I want to install it in a subdirectory. What we have to do is to create a Typo3 conf directory so that DDEV can create the additional configuration file so we don't have to use the database credentials. We start the, oops, one letter missing, the configuration you all know. Oh, that was too fast. We have created a public directory where the base distribution installs the files. This is, there are no files yet, so we have to tell him that's a public folder, and we have to tell him it's a Typo3. So if we look into the public, we see he has created the additional configuration file there. But before we start, we have to change the PHP version. Already. No. Maybe I've forgotten to delete the demo. Maybe he knows it from the other installation. I don't know yet. what we also have to do. Das machen wir aus. So. We have a clone repository, but we have not doing the composer installation. What we can do, we can use a feature of DDEV is what is called hooks. At the end of the config file, you find the hooks section. That means after starting the web container, the commands in this post start will execute it. So the container are fired up, and then a composer install runs inside the container. So. So after creating all the container, it took some time for the composer installation inside. We can also go to the website. So that surprised me a bit. Should be correct. Maybe. Okay, we have a third option to install our Typo3, maybe from the old times. We can also install from a zip file. It's the same, you're creating a directory, you download the zip file. You unpack it, you set the symlinks, then you start DDEV config, DDEV start, and your box is running. For your projects, there are some DDEV commands you can use. One of them is import minus db. With this command, you can, after you have started your containers, import your database dump of your project inside the database. You can use plain SQL files or also zip or .gz files. Another option, import files. To import files to the file admin is just not working in the current version, but they are working on it. For other projects like Drupal and WordPress, it works, but for Typo3, they have to implement it, but it will come. So there are some other commands you can use. You can use the list command to see what DDEV boxes I have set up and if they are running or stopped. You see the names that you have given in the configuration. You see the type, the location where the files are, and the URLs, how to access them. Then one command for the current project is DDEV describe. So you see the project information. In the top lines, the information you have also seen in the list command. You see your PHP version, the URLs, and you see the MySQL credentials. And you also get a hint how to connect from your host to the database inside the container with the example command line. You have also full control with your MySQL guy you like most. So as I said before, PHP MyAdmin is an extra container you can use. And there is also a mailhawk installed. So you can set up your Typo3 to use it and send no mails to the outside, only to the mailhawk. So I will show you what you have to get it running in the moment. You go to the settings and the admin tools and to the configuration, to the install wide options. So in the mail section, you have to change send mail to SMTP. And for the SMTP server, you have to use the local host at port 1025. So, testing is done via the admin tools environment. So, and we send a test mail. It's sent out. And you want to see that it's really sent out. I have to look, get it here. And you see the test mail has arrived. So there's no hassle to send emails to the customers of your customer on the fault. So there are some other commands you can use. You use an exec command. This command will execute it inside the web container Well, we do it with an ls-la. Let's have a look what's inside. You see our web container is the public folder, and you see the files are there. If you are interested what is in the database container, you can add the option minus s for the server and give the name of the container, the web container, and you will see what's in there. You also can have a look at the log files. If you are interested what's going on inside the container. So inside the container, it's maybe also interested what is all installed inside the web container, what you can use for your projects, what you don't have to install on your native on your machine, because it's all inside the container. We can make a SSH connection to the container. And we are in the web root of our site in the web container. So inside the container, you find a Git interpreter, actual 2.1.4. You already find a Composer installation, 1.6.5. What you need in the container for your projects? It's installed. Image Magic you don't use on the command line to set up your projects. You use it inside of typo3. Moment. So. And then I think in the settings. Image processing. So you see in the user bin directory, there are the files from Image Magic. We have to check it. Too fast. That alias is missing.
Maybe what PHP extensions are installed? That's an important question. If you have Redis or Xdebug, is, I think.
Xdebug is installed, yeah. But per default it's disabled. It costs a lot of performance when you use it. You have to. I show you afterwards when I'm on the host machine again. So we have, if you need a Node.js version, it is installed. If you need an NPM, it's installed. Yeah, maybe. A lot of things installed.
I have a further question about PHP or the necessary settings for PHP. For example, if you need for a typo 3 instance, PHP module GD or XML, are they automatically set, or how can I set necessary settings in the init data, perhaps?
That's option to have settings for the PHP ini file, but I have to look into the documentation where the file is and how to do it.
But I guess it's pre-configured to stable run type of 3 in the container.
After the lunch, the workshop is the best place to ask these detailed technical questions. So we what was the question? Oh, for the X debug, that was it. You have to edit the config file. When you scroll a bit down, you will find a Have I missed it? Aye. Yes. No. So you only have to set it to true and you have to restart the container and then it's running with xdebug. And nothing else you have to do inside DDEV. When you are using PHP Storm, you can open your project directory and you can directly set breakpoints and work with it.
I've not understood what you mean with import files.
Okay. No, I show you what I mean. On the top, you will see the command import files for, as I said, for Drupal or WordPress projects. It works and loads the files inside the public directory, the subdirectory where normally the files are lying. For Type 3, they had to implement it in one of the next versions so that you can maybe given an zip file and all.
Upload anything in the file admin?
They should import in file admin then, if they have it implemented.
When I import data, or when I start to develop, and I would use fixtures, database fixtures, can I also import it, or are they normal SQL files, or what is?
Normal SQL files.
SQL files.
Or zipped SQL files.
And if you have SQL Pro installed, then you can connect directly to with the command line here. It's just start SQL Pro.
So let's have a little summary. How you set up your projects. You install them in a directory. You have your, you can choose between Composer installation, installation from Git, or via zip files. You are free how you set up your projects. Then you have to call ddev config to configure your project. To create the config YAML file. Then you maybe adjust some settings like the PHP version, xdebug, or commands that are executed after starting the container. Then you have to start the project with ddev start. Optional, you can, when the container are running with import db, import the data. Today you have to put your files per hand into the file admin, but I think they solved the import files in one of the next versions. If you are ready with your project, you can use the command ddev remove. Then the containers are removed and thrown away, but not the database. When you later on make DDEV start. Database is already there, and you can go on with your project. If you want to remove it completely, you can type DDEV remove minus minus remove data, and the database is already removed. So, I think this is the most important or only information you need yet now to start. Developed by the Drug Technology. I was inspired with an interview on the Typo3 YouTube channel. Then I have tried it out and I like it. The documentation is on ddev-ritzedocs.io. You find the all information about the operating system requirements like Windows 10 or macOS, Sierra, Linux, etc. You find there the installation information, how to set up your system, how to install DDEV, and how to use it. You can also have a look in the source, maybe if you want to contribute and help the guys. And there's also a DDEV channel on Slack where people are helping you if you have questions about DDEV. They react in, I think, very short time and very helpful manner. And sometimes they also create questions on Stack Overflow and answer themselves to get the knowledge out to the public. And if you are interested and want to try it out, you have the lunch to prepare your computer with Composer, and maybe DDEV and workshop by GL. You can try it out and have a lot of more questions.